Okay, hi. This is Dr. Minkoff, LifeWorks Wellness Center. This is fatigue month, I think. So I wanted to talk about fatigue. And part of the causes for fatigue are infections. Viruses, funguses, parasites, bacteria. And we're all exposed to these things. And many, many people, if there's two common symptoms that people come in for, it's because one of them is that they have fatigue and the other one is that they have some kind of pain. So fatigue is something that we investigate very frequently, and infection related to fatigue is very common. If you think of it, the way the body makes energy, you breathe oxygen and you eat food, and these two things go into every cell in the body, and those cells have little factories inside called mitochondria. And those mitochondria take the oxygen and take the food and they turn it into chemical energy. And the energy particle is called ATP. If there isn't oxygen, you can't make energy. And if there isn't food, you can't make energy. So those things are required. And then you have to have mitochondria that can chemically put together the oxygen and the food so that the energy particle is made. If the mitochondria can't do that, you don't have energy. And if it's in the brain, it might be that you feel fatigue, or you have brain fog, or you have poor sleep or poor mood. You know, if it's in your liver and it can't make energy, you may not be able to detoxify or make proteins. So when we think of infection related to fatigue, it's because the infection itself, either the bacteria or the fungus or the parasite or the virus, can get into the area where these mitochondria are, and it can, so to speak, poison them or infect them or produce toxins that block the production of energy. And then when that's produced, people feel fatigue because the cell can't generate enough energy. So there's a whole bunch of viruses, so-called chronic fatigue viruses, that can do this, like Epstein-Barr or cytomegalovirus. These are very common in doing this. Herpes type 6 virus. They can cause fatigue in people, and they can run at a very low grade level, so the person doesn't have a fever. You know, it's not like they'd run to the doctor, but they feel fatigue, and the virus is actually active in their body, in the cell, in the mitochondria, and blocking energy production. And then if we treat those viruses and they go away or they go back to sleep, then there's a resurgence. Like then the mitochondria start making energy again, and the fatigue will go away. So again, this is a common problem. Other infections can do similar things. Some people have parasites. They might have tapeworms or amoebas in their intestine. And they can produce toxic products that then leak into the bloodstream, get into the cells, get into the mitochondria, same thing. So if you have chronic fatigue, if you're chronically fatigued, and it's not related to not enough sleep or some other obvious reasons, it may be that you have a chronic viral or bacterial or fungal infection that is low grade. It is affecting your cells and your metabolism. It might be a chronically infected tooth that you don't even know about because it doesn't hurt, a root canal, a cavitation, something like that. So this should be investigated. And when we investigate fatigue in people, we look very carefully for these various things. You know, your thyroid might be too low. Your cortisol might be too low, or it might be too high. So when we do investigate these things, we sometimes also find that you don't have enough CoQ10, or you don't have enough amino acids, or you don't have enough magnesium or zinc. These also play a role in fatigue, because in order to make the energy particles, you need all these things. So in our hands, fatigue is a very common problem, and it's a solvable problem. And the vast majority of patients that come to see us who have fatigue related to some kind of infection or other problem, that when we find it, we can get them better because we can handle that problem, and then their body goes back to being able to make energy, and then they feel better and their body acts better. Okay? Hope this helps.